What's up, y'all? This is Epic Night Bro, and I can't even use half this trash. Damn it all. Welcome back, everyone, to Dark Souls 3. As good as my word, I have indeed, off-camera, farmed a full set of Lothric Knight equipment, only to discover the sword is a freaking dexterity weapon, and the shield requires far more strength than I have. Well, okay, 2 more points of strength than I have. Whatever. Point is, most of the equipment, the weapon and shield in this set anyway, I cannot use. The crossbow I can use, and I did pick up some ammunition for it. Though in the process, I note that we are limited now to an ammunition maximum of only 99, as opposed to the 999 players were able to carry in the previous Souls games. So it seems that limitations on item capacity follow a Bloodborne model, and I noted that in particular when I saw how many firebombs I could carry at maximum, 20 as opposed to 99 in the other Souls games. So this is, again, following Bloodborne rules, and I'm not sure how I feel about this. For game balance purposes, maybe it works, but for player convenience, it's quite a hassle. And I don't know that I'm entirely happy about this, but I mean, I guess being able to carry 99 of these would allow you to cheese situations more easily, and maybe they don't want that. So, I don't know. I have mixed feelings about this. I note also in the firebomb's description that they do scale fairly well with strength and slightly well with dexterity. So it's interesting to me that once again they've pulled a page from Bloodborne's book in that regard. I did some experiments with the shield and sword and made a couple of interesting discoveries, which I will share as soon as I have an opportunity to fight a weak enemy. More importantly, over the course of farming the Lothric Knights, I made a couple of observations about their behavior, which I think I'm going to share as I proceed, because I don't want to just stand around doing nothing. Oh, also, the reason I'm unequipping all of this stuff is because I discovered that the equip burden mechanics do indeed change your roll speed, but I was expecting them to follow Demon Souls or Dark Souls 1 rules, or else Bloodborne's rules, which are just completely different and do away with equip burden penalties on movement entirely. Instead, it seems they follow the rules of Dark Souls 2, where your roll tier does not become fat roll until about 70% equip burden, which, yeah, it seems to be about 70%. I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they just reuse that system in its entirety. And in some ways I prefer that. My only concern is I do not know how they would handle invincibility frames, or if the current roll class that I have now, which is, I guess, the fast roll, just always has the same number of invincibility frames. Because there's no agility stat in this game which would govern the invincibility frames that I can tell. So either it's based on something else entirely, or there is nothing else, and this roll class just always has the same number of iframes. I am not 100% sure, but it's a point which I'm sure people will begin delving into as the... Oh, interesting. As the life of this game wears on. So I'm going to have to go back up Estus Ring. Gee, I wonder what that does. Increases HP restored with Estus Flask. A green ring crafted from shards. This ring was entrusted to a certain firekeeper, but in the end she never met her champion, and the ensuing tragic farce became a favorite tale of the masses. Huh. That's unfortunate. Even more unfortunate that I'll have to go all the way back up there to get whatever that other item is, but what can you do? And this, unsurprisingly, brings us back to where Katana Guy was. So, with regards to my observations of the Lothric Knights, because boy did I have plenty of time to analyze their behavior as I was farming them, I ended up getting something like... Wait, what? How am I... Oh, are you kidding me? The ring put me over... Yes, it did. Oh, that irritates the hell out of me. Rings have weight in this game. That pisses me off. God damn it. So this is one system I wish they had not brought back from Dark Souls 2, was rings having weight. I really don't feel like that, I don't know, I don't feel like that's reasonable, because some rings weigh more than pieces of armor, and that's just silly. It also means that my issue with the multiple weapon slots and weapons in your offhand that aren't currently being used, still counting toward your equip burden, my issue with that still stands. So, not terribly happy about that. Guess I'll remove this in the meantime. Let's see. So I observed of the Lothric Knights that, first of all, they appear to have infinite or near infinite stamina. They see, oh, for God's sake, are you serious? Really? What is this crap? Come on, FromSoft. Come on, why? In any case, I've observed that the Lothric Knights seem to be able to perform an unlimited number of attacks in a row, and if you are anywhere near within their attack range, they will just keep attacking until they hit you, and sometimes they'll continue attacking after they hit you if you block their attacks. They have the ability to pretty much dash infinitely. They run somewhat faster than player characters, in fact, and although maybe that depended on the equip burden, I might have been at a slower movement speed owing to the fact that I was wearing the full set of armor by the time all was said and done. But at any rate, they run very quickly. They're very good at closing the distance, and they appear to not be subject to any kind of limitation on their dashing at all. So it seems that they can pretty much just run after you until they close the distance to be able to use a thrust attack. And at that point, they'll just use a thrust attack. So they seem very, very relentless. And God, I really hope that this does not kill me. No. Well, it looked like I could have landed there. Guess I'll just try that again. That's another thing. I have no idea where to, or how, rather, where to stand to land that. So, yeah, I kind of get the sense that FromSoft did not put a lot of time into balancing the strength of the Lothric Knights. And this is not unprecedented for FromSoft. The same issue existed in Dark Souls 2, and the enemy that immediately comes to mind for me is the Old Knights in Hade. They had the exact same problem. They had extremely low attack delay. They could pretty much attack without limit, and they could attack so quickly that they left no opportunities for player characters to do anything. They had extremely powerful tracking. Oh, well. Oh, that's great. Okay, I guess I'm trying that again. They had extremely powerful tracking. They would rotate to face you on pretty much without moving. They would just stand in place and rotate. And they were just horribly, horribly broken until I think patch 1.02 or 1.03. So it doesn't particularly surprise me that those same issues seem to exist with an enemy like the Lothric Knights. For goodness sake, this is beginning to get. Oh, well, I sure am glad I didn't have any souls in my bloodstain. Boy, I really appreciate how carefully they troubleshot things before release. But this is another one of FromSoft's habits, unfortunately, is they rush games to release. And I shouldn't even say they rush games to release, because it's a little bit more complicated than that. They push their development schedule for every possible day that they can get to continue adding to the game, rather than going back and polishing what they already have. And in some ways, I appreciate that because it means that they're trying to get as much into the game as they possibly can before they have to go gold and everything is content locked and they can't do anything except update game text and implement minor bug fixes. I appreciate that they're ambitious. The unfortunate compensation of that ambition is they get so ambitious sometimes that they just assume, oh, well, we'll fit in as much as we can and just debug it after release. And the unfortunate effect that has is that the games tend not to be really properly balanced until 3, 4, 5 patches out, which. This is a bit troublesome. Oh, Dragonhead Stone. Nice to know that's in the game. Looking forward to seeing how that works. Also, nice to know that that covenant is a thing.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine hovel.
Mine heart's desire is for those stupid fog gates to not be there anymore.
Ashen One, to be unkindled is I.
You know what?
Farewell, Ashen.
I have an idea. Oh, damn it, no, that's not where I wanted to go. That was my own fault. So, in any case, FromSoft's ambition sometimes causes issues with game balance, and what can I say? I think that what I'm seeing with the Lothric Knights now is one such issue. I certainly hope that's the case anyway. I hope that is something which isn't intentional, and that it eventually gets worked out and balanced. And I hope that they eventually yield more souls, because right now they're really not worth the amount of souls they give you when you fight them, especially if you're trying to farm them. They're not extremely horrible with the battle axe. But I could see classes with lighter weapons like a spear or the scimitars having a lot more trouble with them. I might actually show the farming route that I used to farm this equipment because I have a feeling some people will probably want to get their hands on it. All right, yeah, see this. When we approach from this direction, there's no fog gate. This is clearly a bug. There's no way this is intentional. And that's what I mean. A lot of these issues, I suspect, probably will be worked out. They're just kind of irritating to have to deal with in the meantime. And the easy argument is, well, FromSoft should have just delayed the game and taken more time to get this stuff right. And to a certain extent, I agree. Okay. Firekeeper robe. Oh, this is just Firekeeper stuff. All right. I can't say that that was worth it. Well, okay, that... Can't say that that was worth it either. All right. I wonder if you have to die to get that. I wonder if that was just me not seeing someplace else where I was supposed to land, or if that was the correct route that you're supposed to take, and there's just no other way around it. Huh. All right, so... Yeah, the obvious argument is, well, just take more time, develop the game better, and release it once everything is done. But the problem with that is what FromSoft would do if they had more time is just try to add more stuff to the game rather than go back and fix existing issues. They would just perpetuate the same problem. And, you know, I understand. It's not because FromSoft is corrupt or because they're a bad developer or anything like that. They genuinely want to make good games. And I did have an opportunity to speak a very little bit with President Miyazaki himself at E3 last year. And he left me with the impression that he's just as much a nerd as any of the rest of us. He likes games. He likes having fun. And he wants to make good games. I get the sense he kind of feels ashamed of some of the failings of the Souls series. He is to some extent aware. But I also get the sense that he doesn't necessarily always have the final say in some of those matters. Yes, he is the president, but unfortunately, I think the shareholders and maybe some representatives of Kadokawa and various other forces within FromSoft and within its group of collaborators, and in the case of Kadokawa, maybe people who hold stake in the company. I get the impression that there are people who can step in and override President Miyazaki. He talked about that in one of the Bloodborne interviews, actually. And he touched upon it at least once in his interview with us for Future Press for the one of the Bloodborne guides, where he explained that he had originally wanted for a number of the characters in Bloodborne, such as Yosefka, to survive. And somebody, I do not remember whom off the top of my head, but it was somebody from Sony, stepped in and said, no, you can't do that. Those characters need to die. So, as sad as it is to think that even President Miyazaki does not have total creative control over these games, that is a factor. And it's an unfortunate element, but it's something that needs to be considered before we perhaps allow ourselves to assume that everything is Miyazaki's fault and, you know, this was all his idea. No, it's a much more complex situation than that. And one of probably the most unfortunate aspects of game development in general, particularly within the AAA industry, because indie developers are not subject to this problem to quite the same extent, but one of the most unfortunate things that has compromised the quality of so many games in the past, and even continues to compromise the quality of games, is that it's often the shareholders, the board of directors, the people who are most disconnected and most distant from the players, from the people who are purchasing the games that their company is developing. It is often those people who have the loudest voices in not only development, but also in marketing and in release of a particular game. And what that means is you can often end up with situations where, hey, yeah, the developers have a great game going, they've got this plan, Everything is within budget. It's going just fine. But marketing says, no, we need to change the content of this game because something in it is objectionable or unacceptable, and we don't think it's going to sell well. So then the developers have to go back and either water down the content in question or remove something from the game or mess around with the content somehow and otherwise alter it in a way that is not beneficial to the overall quality of the product. And you used to see that a lot with Nintendo games in particular, especially when Nintendo would port games over to the West from Japan. Things would get watered down, translations would be changed. Sometimes entire... There's the dragon! I knew he was around here somewhere. Alright. Breathe some fire over here. Come on. Oh. Okay, or don't. There we go. Oh, well, thanks. That's nice. So, in any case, the unfortunate result is a lot of games get watered down pretty badly. Oh, right. I don't think... I don't think they want me defeating this dragon. Oh, this is gonna be a while. Well, headshots do 15. The interesting thing about crossbows in this game is that, they have... Let's see if I can show it here. Once you've fired a crossbow, you actually have to reload it as a separate action. And you can also hold a crossbow bolt. There's gotta be a better way to do this, though. Yeah, that's the whole deal with games being watered down. It's just really unfortunate. Oh, is he gonna piss off now? You know, I think if I can get underneath him... I should be safe. Get him to breathe fire a little bit over here. Come on. I wonder. Oh. Really? Boy, they do not want you getting in here. Okay. Now, can I... Okay, this is better. This is better. Whoops, no. Oh, that's the crossbow's weapon art, I guess. How much damage can I do to him? 20-ish? Oh, this is gonna take some time. in before he breathes fire straight down and roasts me. Ah. Hmm. Well, this is... this is a fine pickle indeed. I wonder if I can lock on to him. Does not seem that I can. Yeah, no, of course not. Why would I be able to? Why would I be able to lock onto him from down here? Oh, this is gonna take some time indeed. Did he just leave? No, he didn't. Damn it. Oh, God. Hmm. Okay, well, I'm not going to waste any more time on this. There has to be a better way. This, I remember. Okay. Well, that's definitely much more convenient. I wonder if I can, wonder how much damage this'll do. Fifteen. Well. Oh! What? How? Okay. Alright, well now I guess is a good opportunity to see how much difference this ring makes. Okay, yeah, that's significant. Alright. Of course. Really? Even here it hits me? That is dumb. That is pretty stupid. Hmm. Alright, well, I wonder... wonder if... over here... nope. Oh, and it still hit. My God! Right in the doorway. They clearly do not want you, So either that's going to take bloody forever, or there's gotta be something else. Alright, I'll figure that out some other time then. And if I happen to do it off camera, I'll just bring everyone up to speed as that happens. I wonder... hmm. So I guess he won't do this unless I attack him. Oh, come on. I don't know why I even bother. He's probably totally strong against fire. Just a little more. Just want to see how much damage this does. 15. Nope, not worth. Well, I did everything I possibly could. I'll have to deal with him some other time then. That's unfortunate. I really want whatever he drops. But it's just not worth. Just not worth. Oh, but they finally learned. They finally learned that when you rest at a bonfire, they should refill your items from your inventory. Okay. Rather than having to have you go back to the base as they did in Bloodborne or to the bottomless box. Okay, so this is good. This is good. So they have at least been listening to something. And I forgot to mention it before, but yeah, this is how I farmed the Lothric Knights. This makes it look easy because the weapon art for the axe has hyper armor, but I have a feeling other classes probably would have considerably more difficulty. Stupid thieves. These are another enemy that seems to have infinite stamina. They can run after you pretty much forever, and they will do so. They don't hesitate. Get rid of these guys just to be safe. And then we will explore. I guess there's nothing. Hang on a minute. That chest. The chain on that chest suggests to me that it should be a mimic. I think it contained a divine blessing in the network test, but. Oh, yeah, okay, Yeah, that's a tongue. This is quite definitely a mimic. And you can also tell because the shading on this chest is different from the environment. It's not subject to the environmental shaders as a real chest would be. So, yeah, nice try, FromSoft. But I'm too smart for your shit. Well, doesn't mean I can aim my attacks well. Ah! Yeah, you laugh. You laugh. Stamina. Oh, stamina. Oh, I see it's the Dark Souls 1 mimic. He's still got that soccer kick. Get wrecked. Deep battle axe. Oh, look, and we've got company. Screw you and screw your stupid rushdown. Let's see. 103. Oh, but it does dark damage. Huh. Does dark damage, has no scaling whatsoever. Raises my attack from 140 to 207. So this is basically just an elemental battle axe then, and I wonder if it has some other effect. Alright, well, it's better than what I've got now. Actually, in some ways, it's really good that they provide this particular weapon at this point in the game. Because if you're on a build that has enough strength to wield it, and what did it require? 12, I think? Yeah, 12 strength. insignificant dexterity. 8 dex. It's a really handy thing to have. Oh, and I guess these idiots are, get roasted, fools. Okay. There's only one way this is going to work. I need that. Gonna need that. Please tell me I can still fast roll. Damn it, I can't. All right. The other thing I discovered, and I guess now probably isn't the best opportunity to test it, but was that even if you don't have the strength to wield a shield, you can still use it to block attacks, and it will still block attacks according to its actual damage reduction properties. So let's give this a try. Come on! Breathe some fire, idiot. Oh, but this goes right through a shield anyway. Alright, well, not much point in that, I guess. Well, damn. Okay. It's about time to wrap things up here, so I guess I'm going to attempt to gather all that stuff up next time, and it occurs to me that maybe I should put on a weapon just in case, since I might need it anyway. Alright, thank you all for joining me, and I will catch everybody then for what will probably amount to a humiliating and fairly obvious fiery death. Take care, everyone.